here. Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today, we are going to go over reference styles inside of Microsoft Excel. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description. You might be wondering, what is a reference style? Well, if I'm in Excel and I click on a cell right here and I look in this box, I can see that this is C3, column C, row 3. It's the intersection of the column and row right here. However, there are a couple of different ways to reference cells. The standard one used in Excel is usually the letter across the top of the column and the number down the row. But there is something that's called relative references, or R1C1. And this is something that might be a little more familiar to Lotus users, but it is also the same kind of reference that is used oftentimes when you record a macro and then you go to look at that recorded macro inside of VBA. So how do I go away from the standard reference of letter number and into the reference of R1C1? If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos. Well, if you're using Excel 365, go to File and go down here to Options. Once in there, click on Formulas, and there's a checkbox right here for the R1C1 reference style. I'm going to check that and say OK. And the first thing that I can notice that has happened is now my columns have all turned from letters to numbers. So this is the first column, second, third, and so on. First row, second, third, and so on. So now I have a couple of options for referencing a cell. I can type the equal sign and click here. And look up here in the title bar. You can see a reference to the current cell I'm on. The row is -2. So the negative means I am moving up 2 cells. And then the column is also a -2, so I am moving over 2 cells to the left. So this is what's known as a relative reference because it's relative to the cell that I am on. So if I click here, you can see that the row is doing nothing because it's just an R, but the column is going back -2. If I go down here, I can see that the row is moving in a positive direction, but my column is staying constant. And if I go over here, the row is moving 2 down and the column is moving 2 to the right. And finally, if I click here, the row is moving in a negative direction, but the column is not moving at all. Hence, there's no number there. Another way I can reference a cell using R1C1 is a direct reference equals R5C4. And do you see how while I was typing that, the cursor moved and it highlighted which cell it thinks I'm referring to? And then that is the cell I want to refer to, so I'm going to hit enter. And for now it says a 0, but if I have a value in here, this is going to directly reference the 5th row, the 4th column. The 5th row, the 4th column. So if I change this to 90, that number will change as well. So that is more of a direct reference instead of a relative reference, because it is always referencing row 5, column 4. So if you find the relative reference to be confusing and you've opened a spreadsheet and you've found that you no longer see the letters across the top and you want to change back to the default, just go up to File, Options, go over to Formulas, and uncheck the R1C1 reference style. So hopefully that gives you a quick introduction to what R1C1 or relative references are. If you've used R1C1 before and you've really liked it, please leave a comment below and let others know what you've enjoyed about it. And if you have any other questions or comments, please leave them below. Thanks for watching and see you again next time. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.